Patrick Martin from the Global Mail newspaper.
Did you write the book, co-write the book, The Contenders?
Yes, I did.
I did. I read that. It was very, read that many years ago.
You were 93.
Yeah, 83.
Did I say, yeah, 83. My God, it was 83.
Yeah. Not bad for a guy born in 1969.
No, well, I was born in 51, so it's been a while. In your meeting with Abu Mazen on Monday, the Palestinian Authority president asked you, as one of Israel's best friends, to use your position of friendship to push the Israelis back into the peace process and perhaps to make some accommodation for their demands on halting the growth of settlements. Were you able to speak today to either Minister Lieberman or Minister Barak about that and encourage them, as I think the Palestinian leader had hoped?
Well, the good news is the Israelis are prepared to return unconditionally to the negotiating table. I think I spoke the other day and quoted the Prime Minister as saying we've got to stop the negotiating about the negotiations and get back to the table. So that's the quartet's view, and it's my view as well. Obviously, unilateral actions on either side are unhelpful.
Minister Iris Mackler from CBC News. Do you view the settlements that Israel is building in the West Bank as an obstacle to peace?
I think unilateral actions on both sides, on either side, are distinctly unhelpful.
And the settlements?
That's exactly my answer.
Est-ce que Jeanette Lamarche de Radio-Canada, est-ce que vous croyez que les négociations que vous voulez qu'ils reprennent entre les deux parties, entre les Palestiniens et les Israéliens, devraient inclure les frontières de 1967, ce qu'on appelle the Green Line? Est-ce que ce serait la base?
Je pense que la politique du Canada a été très claire. Selon moi, c'est une bonne idée pour les deux parties, les Israéliennes et les Palestiniennes. De commencer de faire les négociations pour un accord final. Et je pense que tout le monde savoir que les deux parties sont dans le passé à appuyer de faire ces frontières avec les changements, les swaps. Et la décision pour un accord, c'est bien sûr leur décision, pas la mienne.
Donc, mais appuyer sur la frontière de 1960.
I think both. Je vais faire le procès en anglais pour que je serai très précis. I think in the past, both sides have said they would look to 67 borders with mutually agreed upon swaps. That's been their position, and I think that's a direction that they'll pursue.
Minister, Sam Fisher on the radio station. During your meetings here with Prime Minister Netanyahu and other ministers, did the topic of Iran or an attack on Iran came up?
Listen, the situation in Iran comes up at every meeting I have on foreign affairs with any of my counterparts. The situation in Iran, the politics of Iran, Iran's nuclear weapons program, their abysmal human rights record, the amount of trouble they cause in the region through their support of Hamas, Hezbollah, Jihad, groups. It comes up with all Arab foreign ministers, and it certainly came up with my Israeli counterpart.
Did you discuss anything other than sanctions with them?
No, I think the sanctions are beginning to have a good effect. We've got to redouble our efforts to take every single diplomatic measure we could take. The situation, the sanctions do take time to work, and I think you've seen in the last two or three months they certainly are beginning to have an effect. Which means we've got to redouble our efforts and continue to close any loopholes there, and there will continue to be these discussions we have going forward in the future. It's not just the nuclear weapons program, though. It's obviously the human rights situation abysmal. This year, Canada sponsored once again a resolution at the General Assembly. It got more support than it's ever got. And obviously the problems that Iran causes in southern Lebanon and the Gaza Strip, in Bahrain and elsewhere, are well documented and are an equal concern.
Minister, do all these concerns make you support a military strike on Iran?
Listen, I think it's incumbent upon us to take every diplomatic action that we can take. I think President Obama has said everything's on the table, and we're going to pursue the sanctions with great vigor. Just recently, we've increased our sanctions, and we're going to work with others, whether it's on oil, whether it's on financial institutions. I think those represent the best hope at the current time to seek a change in their position.
One more question on the question of Syria.
Sorry, can we give this?
Okay, Jonathan, go ahead.
Jonathan Tomer, the Canadian Press. Given the fact that you said that the Palestinians are coming back unconditioned to the negotiations.
I did not say that. I said the Israelis have indicated they are prepared to come back unconditionally.
Consequently, I ask, do the, in your view, do the settlements continue to pose an obstacle?
I think unilateral actions on either side are distinctly unhelpful. We'll take Patrick, the last one.
On the question of Syria, the United Nations Security Council now is debating a resolution. A lot of it has to do with the Arab League Initiative. Do you believe the Arab League Initiative will be adequate to solve the situation?
I think the sanctions put on by the Arab League have been a welcome development. The Arab League made great efforts in Libya, and their efforts, joining efforts of Canada, the United States, the UK, the EU, have been substantive, and we certainly welcome them. It does make a very different debate when the Arab League itself is approaching the Security Council, demanding action. We strongly support that. There's no silver bullet. There's no magic solution for the challenges in Syria. But I think that that a strong condemnation of the Assad regime's brutality and the violence would be great. I think UN sanctions would also be good.
Do you understand the Russian perspective on this? They obviously don't agree with it exactly as written. They want to try for negotiations and a negotiated end.
And I don't think either a condemnation of the fact that more than 6,000 people have been killed or UN sanctions would preclude what you just described as the Russian position. I have had long discussions with my Russian counterpart, and a full frank exchange of views on that issue. And obviously Canada has a different position, but it doesn't on Syria. A strong UN Security Council resolution condemning the Assad regime's violence, I think, would be welcome. I think UN sanctions on the Assad regime would be distinctly helpful, as have the other initiatives taken by the Arab League. They have stepped in recent months to fill a void that was there, and I think their effort to go to the Security Council is a good one.
Dernière question. Si jamais Israël décide d'attaquer des sites nucléaires iraniens, est-ce que le Canada appuierait Israël?
On va continuer à faire chaque initiative diplomatique qu'on pourrait faire pour trouver une vraie solution pour la situation en Iran. Je pense que le président Obama a parlé, comme j'ai juste à dire en anglais, que toutes les options sont sur la table. Mais selon moi, c'est obligatoire de travailler ensemble avec nos alliés et des autres, de faire chaque chose qu'on peut faire dans le monde diplomatique, et on va continuer de le faire ça.
Merci
beaucoup.